7. Once again, welcome back to the chemistry class. So today what we are going to study, we are going to know a bit more about the changes. Now in our last class, if you remember, we talked about various ranges of changes, right? And then we discussed about the questions. Now during that class, I have already said that major all of these changes, we can generalize them, and they comes under two category of changes. That's where the topic of physical and chemical changes comes. Now we have to know about what is a physical change and what is a chemical change, right? For that, now when we are thinking of any object, their properties, when we can see them externally or from outside without taking the help of any machine, any microscope, any instruments, then we can see the changes in which kind of properties? We can see the changes in their shape, right? In their size, the shape can change when we are stretching a girder or rubber band. It changes in its size, right? It becomes stretchable. Then its shape, it becomes thinner, more thinner. And then its color. You remember if we are dissolving any kind of salt, colored salt, into the liquid, or then what happens? Various kind of color comes up, right? And then we can again revert back them into their other form, right? So when we are changing, there are sort of some changes, there are changing color happens. Then the most important thing that we notice in maximum of the changes, that the state of the substance changes. Now we have already read about what are the state, right? While we were studying about the matter and the state of matter, we have already discussed about the state of the substances and state of matters. Now, how we will term these kind of changes as? They are pretty physical. So, they are the physical properties. So, we can say what kind of properties they are and which kind of changes are happening. So, they are physical properties, because we can observe them from externally, and then they don't involve so much of, because we can revert back to their original form easily, and then there is no involvement within the molecules or anything like that. So how we can explain the physical change? Well, physical changes are that kind of changes where the changes in the physical properties of a substance or a matter takes place without, this is very important point, without the changes in their chemical nature or without the formation of a new substance, okay? Takes place without the formation of a new substance. So, what is the important thing about the physical changes? While a substance is undergoing a physical change, no new substance is gonna form, okay? And no changes in their chemical property or chemical constitution, where it involves the molecules, right? The composition of the molecules and their bonding in intermolecular spaces and various kind of properties, right? Where it cannot be reversed back, it can only be one directional. Where it cannot be reversed, it will be irreversible. irreversible, one directional change, and we cannot get the previous form of the substance or matter back, right? So what are the characters of a physical change will be? First of all, it is generally a temporary change. Okay, why it is temporary? We are going to discuss about that. It is a temporary change, we can say, because this kind of changes generally, these are apparent, they are not permanent. They are taking place, then it will be reverting back into its previous form. Okay, that's why we can say they are temporary. Take an example of the rubber band. We are stretching it, then if we release it, it is retracing back, it is getting back into its previous form, right? So it's a physical change and it's a very temporary. Then they are reversible. What is reversible? Just we talked about that. When a change can be returned into its previous form, suppose ice is melting, okay? So melting is happening where a solid is converted into its liquid form. Ice is converting into its water. Now, if we are freezing this water, we can revert it back into its solid form, that is ice, right? So they are reversible, they are bidirectional. They can go forward and come back. Okay, that's why they are reversible. No new substances are formed. I have already discussed this, that in this kind of changes, no new substances are going to form that cannot be reverted back into its previous form. That means within the chemical composition of this matter, there will be no change. It will be intact. Just a big change in their state can happen. Got it? And then there is the change of physical property. Definitely we were in the initiation of our class, we were talking about the physical properties, right? So while a physical change is happening, some change will take place. No. So what kind of changes are going to take place? The changes will happen within the physical properties, that are the shape, size, color, state of the substances. Okay. No energy change. There will be no there will be no overall change in the energy of the substances basically. Means it will not be evolution with high amount of light or heat, this kind of thing. So overall energy change will be minimum or it will be nominal in range. After that, same chemical properties. The substances will have similar chemical properties, as we have already said that no changes in the chemical composition is going to happen. So after the change has taken place, also the basic chemical nature or chemical property will be intact, right? So water will remain as H2O, right? It will never going to become HO2. No, it's not going to become like that. So the basic nature of the chemical is going to be, will remain intact. So after that, let's take some examples. What are some processes which are pretty much involved with this physical changes? That we have already talked about this: melting, freezing, boiling, condensation, sublimation, deposition. We have already talked about it, right? What is a melting? When we are converting a solid into its liquid state, and that is melting. And then freezing, when we are converting back a liquid to its solid form. Boiling, a liquid into its vapor form or gaseous form. Then again condensation, when we are converting back a gas into its liquid form. Sublimation, where the solid directly converts into its gaseous form. And then deposition is the opposite exactly, where the gas is converted or vapor can be converted back to its solid form. Now, what is dissolving? Dissolving means something when we are creating some homogeneous mixture of two soluble things. or let's take an example of that. When we are talking about, when we are dissolving some of the common salt within water, okay, let's put some common salt within a glass of water, then let's steep that mixture. After some time, we will see all of the salt has been totally vanished and a solution that is salty has emerged. So what is that? The solid has been dissolved within the liquid. So that is what we are calling dissolving of substances within another substance. Got it? So other than that, we can see there are various kind of physical changes, like when we are hammering a piece of solid, say iron, then it can change its shape and size, but its chemical property will remain intact, right? Or if we are melting, suppose during summer, when the expansion of solid happens, what happens? It just changes its state from the solid to a partial liquid, right? But basic nature of it remain intact. Unlike the while cooking, what happens when we are taking a raw rice and then we are boiling it and it is converted into a rice, cooked rice, where we can never convert this cooked rice back to its raw form. So the basic difference between a physical and chemical change is that within a physical change, only the changes happen within the physical properties, not within their chemical properties. That means no formation of new substance can happen by that. So this is what we are talking about, the physical changes. In our next class, we are going to talk a bit more about the question answers, and then we'll move to the chemical changes. So thank you for watching this video. See you in the next class.